Hi everyone, today we are going to discuss about causes of abortion. Abortion. So it is the expulsion or extraction from its mother of an embryo or fetus weighing about 500 grams or less when it is not capable of independent survival is called as abortion or miscarriage. Let's see the causes or etiology of miscarriages. There are various factors like genetical, endocrine and metabolic, anatomic, infections, immunological factors, thrombophilias, maternal medical illness and other. Let's see one by one what are all the causes. Genetical factors. Autosomal trisomy, structural chromosomal rearrangement, other. So there are 50% of chances or majority of cases, early miscarriages are due to the chromosomal abnormality. Mainly autosomal trisomy is most common. So this is autosomal trisomy 16 and polyploidy. Polyploidy refers to the presence of three or more multiple of a haploid number of chromosome and also monosomy. So it is the single most common chromosomal abnormality in miscarriages. And some structural chromosomal rearrangements are observed in 2 to 4% of miscarriages. So this include translocation, inversion and ring formation. Other abnormalities like mosaic, double trisomy are etc. found in about 4% of miscarriages. So this is about the genetical factors. Next, endocrine and metabolic factors. Luteal phase defect, deficient progesterone, thyroid abnormalities and diabetes mellitus. So luteal phase defect results in early miscarriages due to the decreased or insufficient progesterone will cause uterine lining to it will stop the growing uterine lining, and that uterine lining will not get developed. So what happens? Difficulty for the fertilized egg to implant on the uterus. So imagine, so here it has to get implanted. So due to this decreased progesterone levels, there will be a difficulty for the adhesion or implantation. And deficient progesterone. So this poor secretion of progesterone from corpus luteum may cause poor endometrial response to, and finally thyroid abnormalities. So these thyroid abnormalities like overt hypothyroidism or hyperthyroidism is associated with increased fetal loss. And final one is the diabetes mellitus. If woman is suffering with this diabetes mellitus, so when also if diabetes mellitus is poorly controlled, may have the chances of miscarriages. Next, anatomical abnormalities. Cervical incompetence, or you can call it as cervical insufficiency, congenital malformation of uterus, uterine fibroids and intrauterine adhesions. First, cervical incompetence or insufficiency. So either it might be a congenital or acquired. It is one of the most common cause of mid-trimester and recurrent abortion. Next, congenital malformation of the uterus. Like bicornate uterus or septate uterus may be responsible for the miscarriages. So this is normal and septate uterus. So where a septum will be there, it will divide fundal area to two cavities. So due to this reduced expansile property of the uterus and also reduced placental vascularity, and increased uterine irritability and contractility can be seen. And also uterine fibroids, these also may have these may cause miscarriages. So especially of the submucosa variety might be responsible not only for infertility but also for abortions. Uterine fibroid, this is due to the distortion or partial obliteration of the uterine cavity. So due to this uterine fibroids, decreased vascularity at the implantation site can be seen, and also red degeneration of fibroid and increased uterine irritability also can be seen due to this uterine fibroids. And final is the intrauterine adhesions, or you can call it as cinchiae. So it will interfere with the implantation, placentation and also fetal growth. So it depend upon the severity of cinchiae. So these are the anatomical abnormalities. Next, infections. So there are 5% of miscarriages can be with infections like viral, parasitic, bacterial. So viral, rubella, cytomegalovirus and also HIV, and parasitic infections like toxoplasma, malaria will cause miscarriages. Bacterial infections. So ureaplasma, chlamydia, brucella and spirochete. Spirochete may cause there are less chances of abortion before the 28th week because of effective thickness of placental barrier. So this is about the infections. Next is the immunological disorders, in that antiphospholipid antibody syndrome, immune factors and autoimmunity. So it is due to antiphospholipid antibody syndrome is due to the presence of antiphospholipid antibodies. These may cause inhibition of tropoblast function and differentiation, and also activation of complement pathway, and also release local inflammatory mediators, and sometimes it may cause thrombosis of uteroplacental vascular bed. And immune factors and autoimmunity. So these are the immunological disorders. Other like maternal medical illness, like cyanotic heart, if woman is suffering with cyanotic heart diseases, hemoglobinopathies, so these may cause early miscarriages. And also thrombophilias. So inherited thrombophilia may cause both early and late miscarriages. Here I did not mention. Okay. Next, cigarette smoking or any environmental factors, cigarette smoking, alcohol consumption, contraceptive agents, drugs, chemicals, noxious agents. These cigarette smoking increases the risk due to the formation of carboxyhemoglobin and decreased oxygen transfer to the baby, to the fetus. So oxygen insufficiency can be seen. Alcohol consumption, this should be avoided or minimized during pregnancy. And contraceptive agents like IUD in situ increases the risk, whereas oral pills do not do this. Drugs, chemicals, noxious agents such as anesthetic gases, arsenic and lead, formaldehyde will increase the risk of miscarriage. And miscellaneous, like suppose exposure to electromagnetic radiation from the video display terminals, which does not increase the risk. Women can use hair dyes, watch television and fly in the airlines during the pregnancy. So these are the causes of abortion. I hope you understood. If you have any doubts, please contact.